Across the country, thousands of farming families work tirelessly around the clock.
Stop arguing, girls. Give over.
But there's one day each year when they get to leave the daily routine behind.
Right, here we come, Dorset.
Each year in Britain, over 1 million pigs are sent to market. Today we are meeting two farming families who make a living from supplying this huge demand.
Come on, Ginge.
Farmers Barbara Warden and Clive and Hilary Royal with daughter Rebecca are eagerly preparing for the country's biggest Tamworth pig competition. It's a chance to enjoy a day out from the farm, but scooping prizes will also help their business to flourish. However, success will depend on the unpredictable nature of these high-spirited livestock.
No!
These hilly slopes of South Wales Brecon Beacons are home to Farmer Barbara.
That'll do for them.
The proud owner of 51 Tamworth pigs.
Up the field. I'm the main worker on the farm here. My husband helps. He does the feeding at night. We have a trade-off there. I cook the dinner and he feeds.
Their son, Kerry, also lends a much-needed helping hand on the farm.
Nice weather today, isn't it?
But it's no chore for him.
You're looking after the animals.
Go on.
You're feeding them, you're bringing them up. Yeah, you're giving them a good life. So I am passionate about it, and you've got to do it the best way.
Yeah, gorgeous. Aww.
However, it's not all about loving the animals. Farming life is demanding.
The farm's always just about paid for itself. But there have been a lot of structures and things we've had to do. We've had to build new barns. We've had an awful lot of fencing, miles and miles. We've put 40 new gates in since we've been here, and it all costs money. I've got some food for the pigs.
But farming is the only life that Barbara's ever wanted.
Let's go
and
around.
Caring for her Tamworth pigs comes as second nature.
We went for Tamworths because they're the best breed, really, to cope with the conditions we get in the winter up here, because it can be very windy and very cold. Tamworths are one of our oldest breed of pig. They prefer to be out, really, but they haven't got a woolly coat like a sheep has, and they're much better off indoors. Nice big straw barn with plenty of freedom, plenty of space.
Come on, piggies.
On, housing the pigs like this is a huge amount of work. At 9 a.m. each day, Barbara has to muck out their living quarters. And this is more complicated than it sounds.
Come on, pigs. We never let out two litters at the same time because we aren't able to tell which piglet belongs in which litter. And when they go back in, if they've got the wrong piglet in the litter, comes back, then they start fighting.
With the piglets safely separated, the daily muck-out begins.
So it's awful smelly. But that's the nature of the game.
Now for the fresh bedding.
Right, I'll go and get the clean straw.
And this gives Barbara a thorough workout.
Oh, I'm going to have to break open a bale. We're so mean, we can't even afford knives around here. To cut open a bale when you haven't got a knife, put your knee against it. Doesn't usually take that long. That's it, string off.
Right.
I've got the straw.
But this workload never stops.
We muck out every day of the year, including Christmas Day. Christmas Day is very difficult because we have to be in church for 10 o'clock. It's tough in the winter when it's very, very cold, when all the water freezes. Very often the only tap working is the one in the bathroom, so we have to have a hose pipe. Filling buckets for anything up to 80 pigs back in the past was a terrific effort. There you go. Shh. Shh. Go on. If you enjoy what you're doing, it's never hard, is it? So I really have a passion for doing what we're doing. And breeding young animals, this is what it's all about. And then eating them at the end.
Most of the family's income comes from selling the pigs for pork. The piglets are weaned from their mothers at 8 weeks, and 12 weeks later, they're the perfect size for the butchers.
Okay, that's finished then. Jolly good. No real great hardship for them to be weaned and taken away from their mums. And by the time they're 8 weeks old, their mothers are only too glad to see the back of them.
As well as selling her pigs on for meat, she also sells them for breeding. And that's where the shows come in. Because prizes can mean more profit.
Don't tell my husband this, but we do a lot more shows, and I think he really counts up. He wants me to cut down. But I don't. I'm not going to cut down. Why should I? I'm not going to retire.
Shows like these are helping to ensure their survival.
They're actually attractive animals to look at, and we spoke to the breeders, and they have a good temperament.
But not all pigs at everyone's cup of tea.
There are pigs that I'm frankly quite nervous about.
Come on, girly.
I like animals to be quiet and docile. These can be feisty, but are generally very gentle. They like to be stroked every morning. That fits in with the sort of thing I like animals to be. I don't like animals that are aggressive.
Caring for their pigs was just the tonic they needed on retiring. Hilary had been a GP and Clive an army surgeon.
If you have given up a very busy job, you need something that's comparably busy. They're two absorbing lifestyles. They're so different but have similarities going through them if you're looking after animals and looking after patients.
And there's a lot of looking after. One of Clive's daily jobs, come rain or shine, is to feed their 15 pigs.
Weaners, and that's for the sow. The feeding's a bit like my ward rounds of the old days. You do your morning rounds and your evening round and get them settled down. But the morning round is, oh, I enjoy it because it gets you up, especially if the weather's nice, and you do it early and they appreciate it. And then we're off. Ugh. So this is first pen. So there's three girls here, so I'll just go and throw the stuff in. Ugh. Come on, girls. There you go, girls.
Not quite the same as the rounds in a military hospital, but Clive is equally attentive. Especially when he could see that one of the pigs has more than food on its mind.
She's what's called hogging, which is going to be interesting at the show.
It seems that what looks like having a back scratch is actually an indication that a pig is looking to mate. One of their sows is already pregnant, and Clive is anxious not to miss the birth.
This is Pepper, who's due a litter. Come on, here we go. Yeah, you hungry girl. Come on, are you ready? Are you ready? Nah, you're not ready yet. You've got to check the underlines to see if they're producing milk, then they might have babies in the next 24 hours, but we thought she was going to produce last week, but I don't think she is.
In fact, he's found a good way to keep his eye on her.
There's CCTV in there, so we monitor her to make sure that we don't miss the deliveries.
Being so hands-on with the breeding means Clive is quite happy not to get involved with the farm's paperwork.
Only two this morning.
Luckily, his daughter Rebecca is on hand.
Rebecca's already running the business with Hillary doing the accounting side. No paperwork for me, which is very desirable.
Some farms struggle to keep the next generation involved, but Rebecca is so keen she started studying rural accountancy.
Farmers are an incredibly important part in producing our food and everything, and I just love the fact that I can play a small part in it.
They may share a passion for working the land, but they harbour a keen father-daughter rivalry. This even stretches to how to slice the cured kapa ham they produce on the farm.
Dad and I have got an interesting relationship when it comes down to our victory. With his old profession, he believes he's better, but not necessarily quicker.
I like to do it perfectly, Rebecca likes to do it quickly. Yes, Rebecca always likes to finish first.
But this rivalry is put aside when it comes to the shores.
Constructively critical of each other in the ring to try and get the best result. Because we're trying to achieve the same aim.
We always go to try and win. It really puts our name out there. We always hope that our pigs will do well against everyone else.
Back in the Brecon Beacons, Barbara is spending time with some of her lodgers, her seven-week-old piglets.
Come on, pigs. All right, give me the lettuce. Here we are. They've got a lovely lettuce today to play football with. Let's see if they play rugby well. Here you are, pigs. There you are now, then. There's the rugby team. There's 15 weaners now. The other 15 have been sold already and gone to new homes. And they will see Christmas. That's it on the table, I'm afraid. There we are. It won't take long to demolish that. Right, come with me. I've got something special to show you.
However, not all are destined for the table.
Look over here at the newborn litter.
These piglets are born from prize-winning stock and are extremely valuable to Barbara.
Two of the newborn piglets are gilts, in other words, young females, and I've checked them over already when they were born, and it looks to me like they could be potential show pigs for next year.
And Barbara knows the signs. A future champion must have a perfect line of teats.
Their teats have to be in pairs, and they need 12 to 14 teats per sow. Other breeds need more teats because they have larger litters. Oh, thank you. Mind your feet. Thank you. Shh. It's very important even a boar has the correct number of teats underneath in the correct placement, because he's going to pass those on to his daughters. And you don't want to have misplaced teats. Stop arguing, girls. Give over.
Champion boars can also be loaned out to service other herds. This helps Barbara keep the farm afloat.
Of the three boars, we've only got one on the premises at the moment. The other two are out on active service elsewhere. One's on a job down in Tenby, and the other's on a job up in the woods fairly locally. There you are. Have some more.
The only boar not on loan is prize-winning Jasper, though tomorrow's show will be his last.
I do feel very sad when I sell some of my breeding stock. I should be very sad to see this boar go. He's got to go because he's related to all the pigs on the farm. Come on, Jasper, down you go.
You just can't mate relatives, as inbreeding could be disastrous for any piglets and impact the future of the farm.
In you go. He's been a lovely character, he's been super to handle. He's always behaved himself impeccably, and I can't fault him. He's been such a nice chap. I should be very, very sad to see him go.
As well as Jasper's curtain call, the upcoming show will be the last competition for Rebecca's favourite pig, Doris.
Come on. You go, come on. Let's come. I love Doris. She was born on the property. Don't drink it. No. It's got shampoo in, you stupid pig. She's just my pig. We have a good bond. She tends to be much better behaved for me than for Dad and Mum.
Pigs are fiercely independent, and Rebecca's struggling with the pre-show bath.
I don't want her in that muck.
I know. Good girl.
Go on. Back in. She doesn't want to do it. She won't. She is definitely our struppiest of the pigs. Definitely the one with the most attitude. Right, come on.
They're very strong pigs.
That's all the washing she's going to take for today.
Feisty pigs are difficult to manage, which is why they use a board and stick when they are in the show ring. Hopefully it will focus them in one direction and stop them being distracted by other pigs. And a gentle tap with a stick should keep them on the straight and narrow. Of course, this all sounds good in theory.
It is an occupational hazard. If a pig takes it into their mind that they're just going to go for a run, they'll go for a run. You need to be quite fit to manage them. Luckily in the show ring, it is a dedicated area. They can run, but they can't run that far. Unlike here, where they've got a few acres to run in if they want to. And as Bessie did want to this afternoon.
Back over the border in Wales, the other farm has had their fair share of chasing pigs.
I used to have to take the pigs around the ring in the early days, but I gave that up.
When you're showing pigs, you keep your legs together. If you don't, you end up with the pig running between your legs and you ride the pig round. Fortunately, the pig you were on was quite a small one. But that was quite embarrassing, really. I keep my legs together.
No comment.
It's finally time for both families to head off to the show. All year round, they've been building up to this day.
Straight back. Slowly. What?
Since his father's retirement from the show ring, Kerry happily accompanies his mother.
I've been learning everything off my mum, and she's been teaching me everything.
Let's go and get the yellow box.
And I wouldn't trust anybody else.
We take the yellow box to all the shows with us. It's got all our kit in it for the pigs. We've put all our feeding stuff in there, and we've got everything in there that we need.
After you've just been showing off your pigs, it's also extremely useful to sit on it.
Obviously, when we close the lid.
Yeah.
Just fits, aren't we lucky? Right, we're ready.
We're ready.
That's super. Down the carpet for the pigs.
The The next big challenge is to lord the pigs. It's taken years for the families to breed these potential winners, so they can only hope they are willing to cooperate.
There we are. All we've got to do now is load the pigs and we're ready for off. Right, let's go and get the boar.
Come on, big boy.
Come on, then.
First up is Jasper.
Good boy. Down the step. Come on, then. Off to the show.
And he's only too happy to oblige.
Jasper's already packed now, ready for the show. There you are.
On the other farm, troublesome Doris is already loaded up.
She's really feisty, isn't she? Because she's already moved the whole flipping frame around.
But they will have to open the gate to let the others in and hope that Doris doesn't make a run for it.
She'll try and get out if we open up. If she does do a blinder, which she's trying to, which is a bit frustrating. It should be fine, but this is just a precaution that we won't be chasing pigs all around. Come on, then. Showtime.
Come on.
There we go. Good girl. This way. This way.
Yeah, just get it open.
Come on, then. This way. No. Ch-ch-ch-ch. Oh, no, she's gone around that way.
But Doris is trying to make a break for it.
Dad, close it again.
Well, if you just get her out that way.
She won't. She's... Yeah.
I can't do it.
I know, they're going
to
fight.
These two are going to fight.
Dad. Yeah.
There they are. Come on.
Yeah, Dad, just let her out if she wants to come out.
Is she coming up?
Yeah, no, Doris isn't going to the show.
She's not going
She's not going to the show.
Okay.
Doris is staying. I'm sorry, she's not happy enough to go and I'm not going to put her through it. If she's not happy with the run-up to it, she won't be happy down at the show ring.
The welfare of the animals always comes first.
Come on, this way.
And luckily, all the other pigs seem happy at the prospect of a trip.
Come on, girls. Off to the show.
Good girl.
There's a good girl.
All three are going in together.
All done, so that's great.
Right, that's the pigs loaded. Right, here we come, Dorset.
The Dorset County Agricultural Show is beginning to stir. Home to one of the largest pig championships in the country, this prestigious event is a highlight of the farming calendar. The pigs are still asleep. But out in the campsite, Clive and Rebecca are already worrying how they will perform.
I'm hoping they've now got their mindset into the show and they'll behave. Fingers crossed. If not, you'll see me running around the show.
Yeah, they've got their show snouts on.
Yeah.
We're ready to go.
Yeah.
Just got to go and brush them up. I better get into my glad rags for showing.
Yeah.
I'm not going to win any prizes like this.
No.
Let's go.
Meanwhile, Barbara's also been up for hours.
First thing this morning, we gave them a drink of water, we gave them their feed, they had about 3 pounds of nuts, they're now sleeping off their breakfast.
While the pigs get 40 winks, Barbara and son Kerry get the show on the road.
This is our lovely Tamworth breed bunting. We put up at all the shows, it's getting a little bit tatty now. Then we'll have to put Kerry in with the pigs to tie it up for us. But no, we're doing all right.
I like coming to the shows because the atmosphere, you can't beat it. It's like going to a festival or something. It's just everything about it. You get the community, all the people here bringing their own pigs and everything.
Going straight down. I have already been round and had a look at the opposition. The standard of pigs here today is extremely high. It's the judge's opinion on the day. And we have to respect that, whatever we think about it. And I really don't mind, because I know my pigs are the best.
Over in the other pen, Clive may not have any bunting, but he's got a secret weapon.
Some pigs aren't allowed any treatment, some pigs are, and the Oxfords are allowed pig oil. So we just got to see if he'll enjoy it this morning. Hello, boy. Yeah. Let's get you oiled up to make you shine.
The oil is mineral-based and traditionally used on pigs to stop their skin from cracking.
Oh, sorry, boy. Sorry, boy. Get a bit on the ears. The oil increases the contrast between the ginger and the black spot. In the sunshine, they also start to shine a bit, as opposed to... It's probably no different to hairspray. Good boy. There's a good boy. And a judge wants to see a nice, clean pig. Doesn't want any dirt on it.
Right, I've got the washing kit ready.
Barbara's pigs have finally woken up, and she's also getting their shine on.
Doesn't always like being woken up. Come on in with me. You lay down and I can do your stomach, can't I? Come on, yes, lay down. Usually if you tickle their stomach, they lay down for you. There you are. I can now wash her feet.
Lily's getting your white coat on and going in the ring, and if the judge likes what we've produced, it'll be the icing on the cake. Now we're ready. We weren't ready 5 minutes ago, but we're sort of ready now.
We're expecting a very good show today. A little bit of rain, but not too much. It's not too hot, so it's a pleasant day for the animals that are exhibiting. So we're expecting very good attendances. We're expecting a good public response for a nice, friendly family show.
First into the ring will be Barbara's champion boar, Jasper.
We're going to have to be careful with one of our other competitors, Andrew. He's just had a hip replacement, and the last thing he wants is to be bowled over in the ring.
Today's judge is Brian Merry.
Really looking forward to today. Hopefully there'll be some nice pigs here to be judged.
And he has a checklist of criteria he will be looking out for. Strong back legs and a good walk with a leg in each corner. A straight back, not too overweight. And a good underline. This means symmetrical teats, even for the boars. And finally, hairy ears, as this indicates the strength of the breed.
It has got a nice face. It's an eye catcher, you know, and that's what it's all about, to catch the eye of the judge, you know. I think everybody likes pigs, don't they?
Mind your backs, ball coming through.
Two of them, wait.
Yeah.
And in Jasper goes. He's competing against two others in this round. All boars must have two handlers leading them round. They can be extremely dangerous. If even slightly provoked, these males can attack each other, causing potentially fatal injuries. Even Judge Brian has to be extremely cautious.
Right. He's, yeah.
But it's not Barbara and Kerry's victory this time. Another boar trots away with first prize. Jasper returns to the pen. It's not quite the start Barbara had hoped for.
He came third. Out of three, admittedly, but not disappointed. The judge had an extremely valid reason. Oh, I know. It's probably a little bit overweight at the moment, which I tend to agree with.
We take a look at all the other pigs that we're up against the day before or something, but we still have no idea on what's going to happen when we're in the ring.
Right, onwards and upwards. Next one's ready. I'll clean that one. Yeah, I'm really pleased that I've got somebody in the family that can show pigs sensibly and nicely. Though you have been sent out of the ring before now for not having your top button done up. There were two exhibitors there. There were 30 children in the ring with their pigs at Bath and West. And one of Martin Snell, who was judging, picked out the two boys that hadn't got their button done up and sent them out of the ring because he had to thin them out somehow. Unfortunately, you were sent out straight away.
But apart from that, I was amazing.
Oh, I'm sure you were, dear. Mm.
Clive and Rebecca are up next with their Oxford Sandy and Black Boar, Pongo.
Hopefully we'll be in with a good chance. It'll just depend on how the pigs perform in the ring.
Into the ring they go. Pongo has never won before. And today, he's up against his nemesis. A champion boar who has beaten him three times before.
Morning.
Morning.
For these new pig breeders, breaking into the top circle is proving very difficult.
Come on, boy.
Walk up.
There you go.
Walk on.
Good boy.
The judge is taking his time to make up his mind. But he's finally made a decision. And Pongo's done it at last.
Well done. Well done, boy.
Yeah.
Get in there. Get in. Well,
yeah, really
we're
good.
Chuffed. Dead chuffed.
He's a good walker and he'll go on to be a good breeding boar.
There you go. Good boy. Walk on. Walk on.
So being the vet for Clive and his family, it's absolutely wonderful to see them when they're actually getting prizes and sort of getting an end result there. And there's definitely you can see the pride in their faces.
Pongo's done us proud. Caught the judge's eye over the other one. There was only two in the class, but you can't complain with their... With the first?
No.
While Hillary is taking a back seat with today's showing, she's been busy looking at how they could branch out with their show ambitions.
We've been playing with the idea of possibly showing some of our rare breed birds. And we also think maybe we could bring some of our eggs.
I don't see the point of these, because the eggs must be pretty small.
I don't like the look of that.
Here at the poultry tent, there are dozens of birds on show. Like the silver-laced Wyandotte. The silky. A barred Wyandotte. And a gold-penciled Frisian.
We've had better-looking birds than that, really. Yeah.
There are well over 100 breeds and varieties of poultry in this country, from chickens to ducks, geese and turkeys.
Prices are quite interesting.
And these country shows are a good place for breeders to be.
For breakfast, I always have a couple of duck eggs and four rashers of my own bacon. So actually, chickens and pigs go quite well every morning for me.
As well as owning show breeds, these two pig farmers also rescue battery hens.
They were lovely because you felt, because they were commercially at the end, but they did us proud with the
they
eggs.
They did, yes.
And now we've bought some what are called hybrid chickens, and they've been great layers. We've had the best eggs out of them. So
very good layers, and one of them wants to be a house chicken.
Yeah, she's the only chicken out of the 40 that's got come into the kitchen.
Walked in herself.
How much trouble is it to load an egg into the trailer? It's not going to be difficult, is it?
Oh, we put it in the trailer.
If you're doing pigs, I reckon you could load an egg quite easily.
Morning, gilts. January gilts, ring one, numbers 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13.
After a disappointing start, Barbara is hoping to do better with her female pigs. But she's a little nervous about the judge.
The judge we have breeds his own pigs and is very well known for them. This judge won't miss anything. And we know our pigs aren't perfect. There isn't a perfect pig.
Please come with July gilts.
Right, we're ready.
In Vigo. But it's not long before it's chaos in the ring. The judge needs to inspect the four pigs. But there's little chance of that unless the handlers can keep them still. He's finally managed to make a decision. Kerry grabs the first prize, with Barbara bagging the second. An excellent result at last.
I gave them the first and second in that class because the confirmation was right, they walked quite well, and that is why I gave them first and second. There wasn't much between the first and second, actually. It could have gone either way.
So that was a lovely result, that was. No! Kerry and I winning first and second in the class was absolutely super. I think the pigs really deserved it there. I was very pleased with my pigs. I did think they looked absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, it was absolutely amazing. The pigs behaved immaculately. To be honest, it was like I didn't even have to show them around the ring. They just showed them to themselves. So it made my job a little easier.
The day's judging is almost over. Barbara's landed another prize, so has Clive. And Rebecca's also won first prize for her sow, Purdy.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It's made coming to the show worthwhile. Across the field, the same can be said for the thousands of visitors and competitors enjoying everything this country fair has to offer. Now it's the final judging of the day, and father and daughter have a chance to play out their rivalry.
Looks like I'm up against Dad, so we'll see how it goes.
Come on.
Here comes Dad with Pongo.
Come on.
And this is to win the prestigious title of breed champion.
Nothing like being up against your daughter in the champions.
This is a big opportunity for these relatively new pig farmers. And they're up against three other winners. And Rebecca takes the crown, winning hands down with her sow.
The breed champion.
Brilliant. Thank you.
And the best of the show.
Thank you very much. Brilliant.
But in the excitement, she's misplaced her winning pig.
Lost her now.
Bring your pig back down.
Sorry.
See, it's the ultimate sandy and black. Everything about that pig was 100%. It was right. It was correct. All the way through. One we'd take home, as they say.
I'm extremely disappointed, mortified, and it'll take at least three siders to get over the effect that Rebecca won.
The day is almost over, and the crowds are keen to see all the prize-winning pigs. For the two families, all their work has certainly paid off.
This is the culmination of 18 months' work.
It's really paid off. The pigs have done fantastically well and have got us some fantastic rosettes. It really makes the showing worth it when you do have that pig that comes out on top. It's what we put all the time and effort into.
It's been a lovely show here today. We thoroughly enjoyed ourselves, but I'm very hot and very tired now.
I'm feeling absolutely brilliant at the moment. Great to be at a show, great to finally have finished all the showing, and now we can just go around and have a look at the show.
And have a nice drink. First stop, the bar. Come on, let's go.
Across the country, thousands of farming families work tirelessly around the clock.
Stop arguing, girls! Give over!
But there's one day each year when they get to leave the daily routine behind.
Right, here we come, Dorset.
Each year in Britain, over 1 million pigs are sent to market. Today we are meeting two farming families who make a living from supplying this huge demand.
Come on, Ging.
Farmers Barbara Warden and Clive and Hilary Royal with daughter Rebecca are eagerly preparing for the country's biggest Tamworth pig competition. It's a chance to enjoy a day out from the farm, but scooping prizes will also help their business to flourish. However, success will depend on the unpredictable nature of these high-spirited livestock.
No!
These hilly slopes of South Wales Brecon Beacons are home to farmer Barbara.
What could do for them?
The proud owner of 51 Tamworth pigs.
Up the field. I'm the main worker on the farm here. My husband helps. He does the feeding at night. We have a trade-off there. I cook the dinner and he feeds.
Their son Kerry also lends a much-needed helping hand on the farm.
Nice weather today, isn't it?
But it's no chore for him.
You're looking after the animals.
Go on.
You're feeding them, you're bringing them up. Yeah, you're giving them a good life. So I am passionate about it, and you've got to do it the best way.
Yeah, gorgeous. Aww.
However, it's not all about loving the animals. Farming life is demanding.
The farm's always just about paid for itself. But there have been a lot of structures and things we've had to do. We've had to build new barns. We've had an awful lot of fencing, miles and miles. We've put 40 new gates in since we've been here, and it all costs money. I've got some food for the pigs.
But farming is the only life that Barbara's ever wanted.
Let's go
and
around.
Caring for her Tamworth pigs comes as second nature.
We went for Tamworths because they're the best breed really to cope with the conditions we get in the winter up here, because it can be very windy and very cold. Tamworths are one of our oldest breed of pig. They prefer to be out really, but they haven't got a woolly coat like a sheep has, and they're much better off indoors. Nice big straw barn with plenty of freedom, plenty of space.
Come on, piggies.
Housing the pigs like this is a huge amount of work. At 9 a.m. each day, Barbara has to muck out their living quarters. And this is more complicated than it sounds.
We never let out two litters at the same time because we aren't able to tell which piglet belongs in which litter. And when they go back in, if they've got the wrong piglet in the litter, comes back, then they start fighting.
With the piglets safely separated,